Your father?
Yes. You see, when he dies, I shall be
So you invite him?
Yes, I'm afraid so.
I see. Poor little Rishka. Well, I too have had a letter today from your father. He's coming here this morning.
Daddy, coming here?
Yes, he's been to Toulon on business, and I will have a little word with him.
But he won't listen.
Ah, well, we will see. Now, dry your eyes and go to your class.
Excusez-moi, madame. Je ne vous passe au cours. Il est que vous étiez ici.
That's all right, Mademoiselle Merriweather. I was about to go. Soyez gay, ma petite, and trust in me.
What was she talking to you about, Polly?
Oh, nothing. My father's coming here today.
Your father? How thrilling! Is he as handsome as he is rich?
You wait and see.
Now wait for me, Polly. I've let my door be back here somewhere.
Guess who?
Polly! No, you're not supposed to be here. If Madame Dupinet should find us here, I would be asked to leave under a cloud.
She won't find out. I came in the back way.
Well, you must be sure. Anyone might come in and find us here together.
I'm not leaving here till I make you promise me one thing.
Oh, and what is that, may I ask?
You know as well as I do.
Do I?
I want you to promise to dance every dance of the ball tonight with me.
That is out of the question.
Oh, come on, Maisie, be a sport. You know there's no one I'd rather dance with but you.
Really?
Thank you.
you do, Monsieur Brown? I am Madame Dubinet.
How do you do, madam? I hope you'll forgive this visit at such short notice, but I thought that whilst I was in the south of France, I should visit my daughter's school.
Quite so, Monsieur. I am so pleased to meet you. We are all so fond of Polly.
Ah, yes, Polly. She's a sweet girl. Takes after her poor mother. I wish I could see more of her, but I'm taken up with business, you know.
I understand, Monsieur, but I'm quite sure you will not put it before your daughter's happiness.
Polly's happiness? What, she's perfectly happy, isn't she? She never complains in her letters.
Oh, no, I'm sure she does not. But, well, there are certain things, Monsieur, which a girl cannot discuss by post.
Oh, such as what?
Her heart, Monsieur.
Am I to take it, madam, that you're referring to love? I sincerely hope that nothing of the sort is allowed to occur at your school.
Well, I do not encourage it on the premises, but, les jeunes filles seront les jeunes filles, n'est-ce pas?
I don't follow you, madam.
Surely you have not forgotten all your friends, Monsieur Brown? Or should I call you mon petit Percy?
Good heavens! It can't be.
Maybe, Monsieur. It is. Have you forgotten your little Kiki?
No, this is impossible. Most awkward.
But this is no way to greet an old friend after all we've been to each other. Have you forgotten Armistice Night and Maxime's with
me? Yes, ma'am, I've completely forgotten.
But surely not, Cher. I wore a red dress, and you were in uniform. I called you my tiny Tommy, and we drank champagne. There always dogs in the ocean made a box that was all a rash and hairy. Let me see. How did it go?
Excusez-moi.
Oh, you startled me.
I'm sorry, miss. I'm afraid I came in the wrong way. This is the Villa Caprice, isn't it?
Yes.
I have a package here for Miss Polly Brown.
Really? How funny.
Funny? Why?
Well, because I'm Polly Brown.
It's a very pretty name.
Oh, thank you.
And you live up to it. Sorry, miss, I'm forgetting myself. Here's your package.
Thank you.
If you don't mind my saying so, it's an awfully pretty dress.
It is, isn't it?
Yes. I'm sure that you... I mean, it will be the prettiest of the ball.
I don't expect so, really.
I do. I do.
Yes.
Well, perhaps I'd better be going.
Oh, yes. Oh, no. Oh, yes. Perhaps you had. I'd say.
Yes.
You're English, aren't you?
Yes. As a matter of fact, I am.
Well, you don't seem much like a messenger boy.
Don't I? Well, to tell you the truth, I don't usually do this sort of thing. But at the moment, I'm afraid, I'm rather on my beam ends.
Oh, what a shame. And a carnival time, too.
Yes, it is a pity. I was hoping to go to the ball. I'll be watching.
Will you?
Of course.
Well, why don't you come, too?
Me? Go to the ball?
Yes, why not? I've got an extra ticket and... Oh, you must think of me terribly forward.
Oh no, I think you're terribly...
Yes.
I can't see them.
I'll have to see about costume.
Oh, costume. Monsieur Gaston, there's a Pierrot costume. Couldn't you borrow it?
We'll see. How can I let you know?
Oh, let me think. This afternoon, at 3 o'clock, I'll be on the plaza, by the bandstand.
By the bandstand, at 3 o'clock. Goodbye till then.
Don't know. much prettier.
Not so sure about that. I'm beginning to think we should have gone there in the first place.
Oh, nonsense, nonsense, Hilda. Nothing like a change of routine for old people like us. In fact, I feel 20 years younger.
And behaving accordingly, I notice. Really, Hubert, how can you ask for a loss?
Now, Hilda, don't take on so. After all, Tony isn't dead.
He might as well be. Sometimes when I think of the disgrace, I would rather he were.
Now, Hilda, after all, the boy has done nothing wrong.
Nothing wrong? Disappearing from Oxford in the middle of the Hillary term? Ruining a brilliant career, why, they won't even consider it for the constituency now.
Yes, well, never mind. Perhaps the boy has found another career.
But he hasn't any money, Hubert. Not a penny to his name. Oh dear, it gives me palpitations every time I think of it. I should have to go and sit in the shelter.
Yes, very well, dear.
Well, it's worth it. Right,
how about you, Polly?
Oh no, I think I shall have a stroll. Oh, well, let's leave her alone, girls.
Okay. Bye, Polly.
Gaston about a costume, and it's all right.
Oh, now I shall really enjoy the carnival ball.
So shall I. Jove, I never thought I'd be going with anyone like you. It makes me rather nervous.
Nervous? Why?
Well, me, just a messenger boy, and you, a rich young lady from the Villa Caprice.
Rich? Oh, I'm not rich. You see, I just work there as Madame Dubonnet's secretary.
Do you honestly? Well then, we're not so different after all.
No.
I'm so glad. I thought you'd only like the grand life. You know, big cars, diamonds, champagne.
Oh, no. I'm quite content with the simple things.
How ripping! So am I.
Life of wealth does not appeal to me at all. Do you agree at all?
I do.
The mere idea of living in a palace is so full of fallacies.
That's true.
I've got a very different sort of scheme in mind. It's just a dream designed for two. Would you care to hear about it?
Can you doubt it, dear?
All I want is a room,
What if Madame Duvernay should find out?
Oh, Hortense, let me talk to you.
Well, shall I go?
Oh, no, I won't be a minute. Please, Hortense, don't betray me. I know he's just a messenger boy, but he's doing it because he's poor. And I'm sure that in reality he is well-born as I am.
Perhaps so, but he has no right to make advances towards a young lady like yourself in his present condition.
But he thinks I'm just a secretary.
You told him that?
Yes.
Et là, quelle situation!
Hortense, please don't let on to anyone. I'm so happy to have an admirer who isn't just interested in my wealth. Surely you must know how I feel.
Perhaps I do. But if Madame Duvernay should find out...
Oh, but she won't. That is, unless you tell her.
All right, ma petite. I give you my promise. After all, it is carnival time.
Oh, thank you, Hortense.
Oh, here come the other young ladies.
Come on, honey, let's go. I don't want to meet them just yet. They do chatter so.
All right, Polly. Let's get back to the promenade.
Goodbye, Hortense. And please remember, you promised. I say, wasn't that Polly?
I'm sure it was. I recognize her frock.
Oh, Hortense, do tell us. Was that Mademoiselle Brown in her bow?
I have no idea.
Oh, please, do tell us.
I do not know what you are talking about.
Oh, she is so mean. If you'll just tell us who you thought on, I'll give you my handkerchief. And I'll give you my crochet flowers.
Does it fool themselves?
Hortense, I believe you have.
Oh, Hortense is not as prim as she pretends.
Of course she isn't. After all, she is French.
Yes, I am. I'm very proud of you, too.
Kiki,
all right, Kiki, but I've changed my
mind, I don't want to bathe after all.
But why not, Sherry? It'll do you some good.
I can't swim.
I think you tell a little fib, yes? I bet you swim like a fish, you know, big muscles.
Stop, Kiki, I'm ticklish.
I know. I remember.
Someone will see you.
This is the Riviera. Now come along, let's have our bathe.
But I've forgotten the bathing costume.
Gone, Nefarian?
You don't mean that I should bathe with that?
No, but I know where I can borrow one for you. You stay here. I'll return and dust when it's so.
But Kiki.
Oh, what? Mon petit poisson?
I say, old chap.
Were you addressing me?
Well, I wasn't addressing the bench. Actually, old boy, I was wondering if you could help me. You seem to know your way about here, all the joyous girls. I'm a stranger here, you see, and well, what's more, I've got the wife in tow. Now, she's not a bad sort, really, but well, she doesn't understand me.
I'm afraid I can't assist you in your domestic affairs.
Oh, I don't want assistance in my domestic affairs. It's foreign affairs. Oh, don't be so standoffish, old man. We Englishmen abroad must stick together, you know.
Yes, of course.
Oh, who is that young lady you were just dallying with? She's seen a right sporty little filly.
A sporty little filly? Sir, I must ask you to moderate your language. That lady is a highly esteemed member of the community.
Yes, I'm sure she is. They manage these things so much better in France.
She is, sir, a headmistress.
Oh, look, here she comes now. An appeal, good fellow, and introduce us.
Look, Percy, the latest model!
I'm sorry, madam, I've changed my mind. I'm going straight back to the hotel.
But, Percy, I thought you such a lovely costume.
Yes, go on, little chap. Do as she says.
I've had enough of this. I'm leaving at once.
Are you, Percy? But why? What have I done?
I say, old boy, you're upsetting her. Now, that's no way to treat a head. Mistress,
will you go away?
But Percy, will you not introduce me to your friend? Perhaps he would like to take a bath instead.
By Jove,
shot. This man's even stranger to me. I've never laid eyes on him before in my life.
Ah, but this is France, my good man. We can afford to dispense avec les formalités.
I
have no idea what that means. Absolutely
delicious. Well, what are you doing now?
Botheration, I was just showing this lady and gentleman.
Hubert, come here at once.
Yes.
Hubert?
Yes?
Remember, we are British.
Oh, the poor Rapido.
Really, what an embarrassing situation.
I think you're a little jealous, no?
Not a bit jealous. I just like for people to behave decently, that's all.
Just as we are beginning to enjoy ourselves.
I must have been out of my mind.
You are what they call a dumb blanket. You spoiled all the fun.
Kiki, it's high time you realize things are different from what they were.
Are they, Percy?
Yes, most definitely.
Thank you.
Which one of us you played out?
Right, Polly, the coast's clear.
I think perhaps I'd better be getting back to the villa. I've got some letters to type.
Oh. Do you have to go so soon?
Yes, I'm afraid I must. But I'll see you tonight at Bond, won't I?
Well, I should jolly well think so. Where shall I meet you?
I don't know. You say.
How about the Café Patapon at 9 o'clock?
Lovely. I shall be waiting for you.
It's going to be a wonderful evening, isn't it, Polly?
Yes, it is, isn't it, Tony?
It's going to be the first of many wonderful evenings, isn't it?
Yes. Well, at least I expect so.
But why shouldn't it be? Remember what you said this morning.
What did I say?
I could be happy with you.
Thank you.
I'd feel happier if I knew how Polly was. She seems so miserable this afternoon.
She is in love.
In love? Do you honestly believe that?
Yes, Mom, I do. It is a woman to understand these things.
I'm beginning to believe you're right. Perhaps Polly misses her mother more than I realize.
Well, every girl needs a mother when she is young.
I've been selfish, Kiki. I neglected Polly. When she needed me most, I was far away, so she turned instead to you. And for that, I shall always be grateful.
It was then. You know, sometimes I feel as if Polly were my own daughter.
She could be, Kiki. She could be.
What did you say, Bishop?
I've been a fool to pretend the old person was dead. Oh, Kiki, you're just as beautiful as ever. Since no time stood still, what's been dancing around the cafe?
And you said you wanted this night to go on forever?
Oh, Kiki, give me that champagne.
So you're beginning to remember?
Yes, Kiki, I am beginning to remember.
Time. And old master, it's never too late to be like cool. And who, may I ask, was that?
Oh, that was just an acquaintance, my dear. We were merely passing the time of day.
What? At this time of night? Really, Hubert, you are disgraceful.
Disgraceful? But at least I wasn't misbehaving.
I'm not so sure. In any case, I can't think why you should wish to attend this wicked ball when you know how distressed I am. Our experience this afternoon has quite unnerved me.
Now, Hilda, don't take on so. Please sit down, and I'll ask the garçon to bring you a glass of port.
I don't require anything to drink, thank you, Hubert. I intend to return to the hotel in a few minutes. I shall expect you to accompany me.
Yes, very well, dear. Garçon, please bring the lady a glass of port.
Oh, we look sure, 2-3.
Boy, dear.
Child, how sad she looks. I'll go talk to her, ma'am. Hubert, I think that's the girl we saw with Tony this afternoon.
Are you sure?
Positive. Perhaps if we talk to her, she might be able to tell us his whereabouts.
Yes, I'll have a word with her in a minute.
No, Hubert, we will both have a word with her later!
Molly, you look charming tonight.
Do I, Maddie?
But of course, you know, you were too wise to come to the ball tonight. They say when one is feeling sad, the only thing you can do is try and forget.
I shall never forget.
Courage, mon brave. In the meantime, why not enjoy yourself? All your friends are around you, so do not be downcast.
I'm so glad you've come, Molly.
Oh, we will miss you like mad, didn't we, chaps?
You're both fun, Molly.
Thank you. So nice to know I've got some real friends.
Attention! Attention! Madams, messieurs, s'il vous plaît, we now bring to you the rage of the continent, Pepe, Ilolita, who will now dance for us the Carnival Tango!
Revolting!
Thank you.
am Pierrot, you are Pierrette. Surely we are not strangers.
But I don't know who you are.
Perhaps this will remind you.
It isn't.
Yes, Polly. It is I.
Tony!
Polly!
Gilbert! It's Tony we found in the last.
Tony! My boy!
And who, may I ask, is this young man?
This, is the Honourable Tony Brockhurst.
The Honourable Tony Brockhurst?
Yes, Polly. I'm afraid I'm not a messenger boy. Can you forgive me?
Yes. And who, may I ask, is this young woman?
Why, this is my daughter, and I am Percival Brown.
Percival Brown the millionaire?
Yes, Tony. I'm afraid I've deceived you, too. I'm Mellinoff's secretary, after all. Can you forgive me?
Of course, my darling.
Oh, la la la, since love's in the air
tonight. It is indeed. Polly, I have some news for you as well.
Have you, Daddy? How thrilling.
May I tell her, Kiki?
But of course, she should be the first to know.
Very well, then. Polly, Madame Dubinet has just consented to become my wife.
Maisie, midnight. What about my proposal? Have you thought it over yet?
Et toi?
Et toi?
Et toi?
Et toi?
After due consideration, we have come to the conclusion that the answer is
unanimously
yes!
Well, now how about that Charleston?